From Fox Television, this is the Fox 13 10 o'clock news.
A roundup of sexual offenders and predators means hundreds of them are back under the watchful eye of police tonight.
And a death during childbirth leads police to investigate two women for acting as midwives without proper training.
And we have some breaking news on I-4 tonight, where emergency crews are on the scene of a double fatal accident.
Good evening. I'm John Wilson.
And I'm Kelly Ring. And we begin tonight with the breaking news.
That's right. It's a horrible wreck, as Kelly points out here tonight. It shut down the eastbound lines of I-4 near Plant City. Sky Fox over the scene at I-4 in Alexander. At least five cars are involved in this wreck. Two people have been killed. Troopers are diverting traffic now off the interstate at Thanatosassa, but eastbound traffic is backed up for miles. Investigators are trying to sort out what happened. There is no word right now on how long these lanes will be closed, how long it'll take to clear it up. Again, this is the eastbound lanes of I-4 near Plant City. And we're getting word of another breaking story tonight, a deadly shooting involving a police officer. Sky Fox flew over that scene in the River Hills area a little while ago near the Hillsborough River where this took place. You can see a slew of police lights as officers investigate this on the ground. We're told it started when police tried to pull a man over. The TPD says some kind of fight then broke out between the man and police, and the man was shot to death.
Well, one side calls it a religious sect that preys on vulnerable pregnant women, and the other side says they're God-fearing Christians who help deliver babies without the aid of doctors. Tonight, a man is grieving the death of his wife, who died delivering their son. Fox 13's Glenn Sully reports the man's mother is among those now facing charges.
Keith McGlade and his son Gabriel, who's 5 months old now. In so many ways, Gabriel is a miracle baby because his mother, 25-year-old Mara, died just hours after giving birth.
I miss my wife. I have a hole in my heart right now that, you know, will probably never be fully repaired.
While Keith McGlade grieves, his mother, Linda, and his sister-in-law are both charged in connection with the death. According to the police report, both of them acted as midwives for the home birth, but neither is licensed. They have no schooling or formal training.
None other than doing it, you know, several times, you know, illegally. That's it. Luckily, no one else has lost their life.
Right from the start, police suspected something strange about this case, because almost immediately they began to hear rumblings about a connection to a cult. The allegations come from former members of the family church, but police haven't been able to substantiate them. Keith McGlade says he and his family are deeply religious. He says what happened is just a horrible tragedy and an accident, and he doesn't blame his mother.
It was our choice, Mara and my choice, to have our baby Gabriel born at home. You know, through what has happened, it seems like a root of bitterness has sprung up in the body of Christ. But, you know, we pray that God will bring reconciliation.
Their attorney says accusations of a cult are way off.
Anybody that knows the McGlades would certainly not refer to them as a cult.
They literally knew she needed help. They literally stood by and watched her die.
Mira Skrobot is Mara's mother. She and her husband live near Chicago and believe their daughter didn't just die. She was killed because of negligence.
I believe it's murder to stand there and watch somebody, and you can help them, but you don't. It's murder.
Detectives back in Florida think differently.
Understand that, you know, the family, you know, lost a loved one, and they, you know, they feel like their daughter's been murdered, but you know, we don't have any evidence of any other thing than other than what they've been charged with, which is practicing midwifery without a license.
Detective Price says the investigation is still open. Linda McGlade, even as she faces charges relating to the death of her daughter-in-law, helps raise her grandson. Detectives say they're also looking into whether she may have been involved in other births that ended in death. In Bradenton, Glenn Selig, Fox 13 News.
Linda McGlade and her daughter-in-law both face a third-degree felony for acting as midwives without licenses.
Stung by the recent deaths of children involving convicted sexual offenders in Florida, waves of law enforcement officers are sweeping across the state. They're rounding up sexual offenders who have slipped away from community supervision. As Fox 13's Jim Hill is going to tell you now, many more arrests are expected.
Mr. March.
Law enforcement go door to door, aggressively tracking down sex offenders and predators.
These people, they're like any other type of criminal that we have. They hide, you know, they don't want to go by the rules, obviously, or their addresses would be updated.
In a month-long sweep, authorities arrested 63 sex offenders in the Tampa Bay area for not living at their registered addresses. According to a review of a state registry, Florida agencies had lost track of at least 1,800 sex offenders, 1 month before convicted sex offender John Cooey allegedly kidnapped, raped, and murdered 9-year-old Jessica Lunsford in Citrus County.
A little bit behind trying to catch up and make sure it's a big fluid system. There's, you know, thousands of these people across the state. So to keep track of it and just make sure we're on top of it and they know we're coming.
It was a combined effort. Local authorities teamed up with the Florida Department of Law Enforcement and targeted absconders across the state. Governor Jeb Bush says it's just the beginning.
This, as I said, is part of a comprehensive strategy to deal with the fact that sexual offenders, particularly sexual predators, have committed atrocious crimes and if we're not vigilant, can continue to do so.
As part of that strategy, the FDLE has also unveiled a new website called FloridaSexOffender.net. It lists sex offenders living within a certain mile radius of your address.
You can enter an address that could be your residence address, it could be a daycare or a summer camp that your child's attending. So it gives parents much more flexibility than we used to have.
Authorities are trying to track down more sexual offenders. They have outstanding warrants for the arrest of 40 sexual offenders in the Tampa Bay region. This encompasses an 8-county area. In Tampa, Jim Hill, Fox 13 News.
203 people have been arrested across the state, 203 who are registered sex offenders and predators. Hillsborough County deputies say they'll look for more of them in the next few weeks.
Both sides in the terror trial of former USF professor Samuel Arian have agreed on a jury, but the defense still wants to move this trial out of Tampa. A panel of 6 men, 6 women, and 10 alternates were seated today at the federal courthouse. They were chosen after 3 days of intense questioning. Al Arian is charged with aiding a Palestinian terrorist group, and his attorneys say they're still not convinced that he can receive a fair trial because of all the media coverage here.
Deputies in Sarasota locked down schools today while looking for a suspected murderer. The sheriff's office got a 911 cell phone call this morning. They brought them out to 301 and 27th Street, and there they found a man dead, 19-year-old Darrell Lamb. They quickly locked down Booker High and elementary schools while they look for the killer. Detectives have no suspects and no motive in the homicide. And a Sarasota County School employee has been accused of having sex with a student on campus. 45-year-old John Allen Jones has been charged with sexual battery on a minor. He works as a security aide at Sarasota High School on South Tamiami Trail. Police say instead of working, though, he had sex with the student during school hours. The incidents allegedly happened in February. Jones is now being held without bond.
Hillsborough County has a new superintendent, and the choice does make history. Mary Ellen Ilya is the first female in the district's top job. Ilya started out as a teacher in Hillsborough County, moved right up the ladder during the past 20 years. She started the district's magnet program, and most recently she was in charge of all new school construction. She replaces Dr. Earl Leonard, who is retiring.
The first priority is making sure that as we receive the test scores on our district, which is a roadmap, really, if you will, of what our next year is going to look like, that we very closely analyze that, and for those schools that are having difficulty, give them all the support that they need to be successful.
Ilya says she's going to work with Dr. Leonard to make the transition as smooth as possible. She'll officially take over in July. Well, FCAT scores are inching upward across Florida. Results released today show that just over half are now reading at or above grade level. While Governor Bush says there is obviously still a lot of work to do, he is encouraged by this improvement.
When you can start adding up on an annual basis that thousands and upon thousands of young people are reading at grade level at the appropriate time, just as they begin to acquire knowledge in their education experience, you can see that a generation from now, or a half a generation now, the benefits that this will bring to our state.
Here's a closer look at the scores, too. Statewide, 51% of students in grades 3 through 10 are reading at or above grade level. Results are slightly better in math, with 56% meeting grade level requirements or even better.
Two people have been hurt in an automobile accident, and this one involves a car and a house. Police say a man and a woman were driving out of a discount store parking lot in Clearwater tonight. It is very near a home on Gunn Avenue, and somehow the two crashed into the home carport there, striking a parked red truck. Crews had to use the jaws of life to get them out of that twisted metal. They're now in the hospital being treated. And a woman in St. Petersburg woke up today to find her living room had been turned into an unexpected parking lot. A truck came crashing through Christina Caspina's home on Harding Boulevard Northeast just before 2 this morning. Police say a teenager who had stolen that truck caused it. Nobody was hurt, but there was thousands of dollars in damage done there.
Well, it is weather time now, and Paul's here with us talking more about Hurricane Adrian over in the Pacific. Paul?
Just about ready to make landfall in El Salvador. In the meantime, we'll be talking about that, plus we get some showers and thundershowers moving offshore. Here's a satellite loop of Hurricane Adrian. Again, it's just about onshore, interacting with some very high mountains that go up to 8,000 feet up in the sky. We'll talk about that. We'll talk about a weekend preview coming up in about 5 minutes. We'll see you then.
We'll be waiting. Thank you, Paul. Well, some gators may be looking for a new home after getting too big for St. Pete's Lake McGorry.
And Allstate Insurance is saying goodbye to some Florida customers, but how's the rest of the industry doing after last year?
I'm Charlie Belcher. This is Zach. This is Alex. The three of us are about to ride the brand new scariest roller coaster in the world at Busch Gardens. It's called Shikra. You nervous?
No.
Are you nervous?
Definitely not.
I'm scared to death. Stick around and see how this turns out.
For 50 years, Fox 13 has led the way. And coming soon, we're adding new technology that will give us the most advanced weather center in America.
Adaptive headlights designed to turn with the road ahead. The luxury sedan designed to outperform. Introducing the all-new M from Infiniti.
Just steps away from Bourbon Street. In the world-famous French Quarter, there's a place where everything feels a bit more spontaneous. Where you can indulge and cut loose. And it's all waiting just for you. Come on, it's New Orleans.
Horsepower Acura MDX with electronic four-wheel drive. Because you never know what nature might throw at you.
I'm going to stop all violence.
Ernest lives on the most violent street in the city of Buffalo.
Without partners in life, you're not going to be able to accomplish anything. And that's why I think Target has been such a great influence on our foundation.
I had children that were reading 2 years behind grade level.
I'm doing better in math and social studies.
Tiger and Target taught them to believe that they were possible.
It made me feel like I could do something in my life.
It's amazing what can happen.
At a department store, you can get a big and tall suit for $475. K&G has big and tall suits that look just as good for less than a quarter of that. K&G Fashion Superstore. For men, for less.
A remarkably spacious cabin. Designed to breathe. A luxury sedan designed to outperform. Introducing the all-new M from Infiniti.
Satellite TV. See if it's right for your ride. Friday at 10.
You're watching the Fox 13 10 o'clock news. Tampa Bay's number one primetime newscast.
Allstate Insurance is going for another rate hike and dropping thousands of existing policies.
The company blames recent hurricanes, of course, but Craig Patrick joins us now to show us how Allstate and many insurance providers are actually making healthy profits. Craig?
Sure thing. Allstate and other leading insurance providers did, in fact, lose money last year on home policies in their Florida branches. But despite those hurricanes, those same insurance companies are making billions of dollars overall.
Sandra Kapp says the soaring cost of insurance may soon drive her and many of her neighbors out of their homes.
It would be devastating. I've lived in this house since 72.
Insurance companies cite losses from the hurricanes of 2004 as reason for canceling policies today and charging higher rates. Allstate is the latest requesting a rate hike while dropping 95,000 Florida customers.
It was terrible. The only thing I could think of, so please don't have mine do that.
But while insurance companies continue to blame rising rates on hurricane payouts, statistics suggest the property insurance industry just enjoyed the most profitable year in its history. Despite hurricanes Charlie, Francis, Ivan, and Jean, insurance providers racked up more than $28 billion in profit in the first 9 months of 2004. According to a Fox 13 analysis of statistics obtained by Weiss Ratings, industry profits rose 22% from 2003 to 2004.
It's mind-boggling that they would have a record profit year and then hit us with more rate increases on top of that.
Insurance companies cite the same Weiss ratings that also show while providers may have earned billions nationwide, they did in fact lose hundreds of millions in the state of Florida last year. But consumer advocates say Florida residents may have many more options and lower rates in coming years. That's because new insurance companies are now entering the Florida market, and the broader investment market is on the rise. That's where providers make profit, and that's when they tend to write more policies in higher risk states like Florida. Another insurance company has already agreed to take over the 95,000 policies jettisoned by Allstate. That includes some 2,000 policies here in Tampa Bay. And consumers groups say that is a very positive sign of more competition and perhaps lower rates yet to come. John and Kelly.
Well, that would be a very good thing. Thank you so much, Greg.
Yeah, that would be a surprising development.
It certainly
in fact,
would, and we'll take it.
Yeah, here we are. Not even in the hurricane season. We've got a hurricane to talk about. We're not over four hurricanes last year yet.
I wonder how the home insurance industry is in El Salvador.
I'd say their blood pressure is sky high right now.
Yeah, absolutely. And they're preparing because they've got a storm offshore. Usually they're watching hurricanes and tropical storms approaching from the east. This one is approaching from the west, and that's the first time I've looked back in the record books. I couldn't find a hurricane that made landfall along the west coast of El Salvador coming at them from the west, but it's happening tonight. We'll talk about that at length. In the meantime, we've had a busy evening in Pinellas County. Some showers and thundershowers building right along that late day sea breeze. I talked about that sea breeze, how it was pinned right to the coastline. So the storms were heaviest in Pinellas, and some spots had over an inch of rain. Also along 19 in Pasco County, heavy rain. That rain is now moving offshore. Here's some rainfall amounts from today, courtesy of Doppler radar. And as you can tell, it was all lined up mainly along US 19. Northern Pinellas up by Dunedin had over an inch of rain. Heavy rain up by Port Richey. And there was some showers earlier today by Plant City and Lakeland. Besides that, most of the region was free of rain along with a good supply of sunshine. Watch what happened late in the day. The storm's igniting right on the sea breeze. It was a good east wind today. So the sea breeze, instead of being along I-75, was pinned right along the coast. Now the sun's gone down. The east coast wind wins out. The sea breeze goes away, and the storms move safely to the west and southwest. Cooler where we've had some rain, Lakeland is 75, Punta Gorda is 74, Tampa 79, Clearwater 82, and St. Pete at 81. A few high clouds over the peninsula today will move down to the south and the southwest. We'll show you what is going on now with Adrian, which is just about ready to make landfall on the coast of El Salvador. Not looking quite as impressive on the satellite loop tonight because some of the higher mountains are interacting with that circulation, disrupting the circulation. Because the terrain is so hilly and mountainous, mudslides are a good possibility tonight and tomorrow, where up to 20 inches of rain could easily fall, especially over the higher terrain. 13.1 north, 90.1 west. Top winds have decreased to 80. And Adrian is moving northeast at 9. And all the computer guidance I've looked at tonight, I agree with this, is that the storm will weaken dramatically over Central America. The environment in the Caribbean Sea is not conducive to re-intensification. There could be a tropical depression at some point in the Caribbean Sea. should not be a big deal. This system will stay south of Florida, maybe some showers over Cuba during the weekend, but for the most part, it's a big, big rainmaker for Central America. 79 now, dew point 62, east wind at 9. Lows later tonight, about where they should be, near 70. Tomorrow we're going to see an east wind becoming south and southwest by nighttime, highs in the upper 80s. Sea breeze showers dying down tonight. Over the weekend, we'll be watching an approaching backdoor cold front coming at us from the north and the northeast, and that front may help to ignite more showers and thundershowers on Saturday, then turning a bit drier on Sunday. Becoming clear and mild tonight, down to 70. A few afternoon thundershowers tomorrow, 87. Slightly better chance on Saturday with a high of 85. Winds becoming onshore, seas 2 feet or less, bay water a light chop. We have a high tide at 12:32. We have a Sky Tower 7 day that drops the rain chances on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. John and Kelly.
All right, Paul, thanks. The governor makes a decision today on a bill that would crack down on slow drivers in that fast lane.
And some gators in St. Pete's largest lake may be a little too big for their own good.
Fox 13 weather is sponsored by Terminix.
It's ant season. Terminix them with the protection more homeowners believe in. 1-800-TERMINIX. It's roach season. Terminix them with the protection more homeowners believe in. 1-800-TERMINIX.
There's one thing that's true about cable. You can't take it with you. TVs are hot items in anything that rolls. And now there's a way to get hundreds of channel choices. Satellite TV. See if it's right for your ride. Friday on the Fox 13, 10 o'clock news.
Now that they're married, Laura and Tim have some decisions to make.
Okay, whose bank?
My checking account's free.
Well, so is mine. But Wachovia gives us free online bill pay. We get a free check card, which can earn reward points, and we can use over 5,000 ATMs.
Okay. Wachovia.
Definitely.
Now, what goes there?
At least choosing a checking account was easy. Switch to extra free checking. Wachovia.
The all-new 2005 Equinox. An exciting new crossover from Chevy. It'll turn daylight into limelight. Now get a 2005 Chevy Equinox for around $20,385.
I know you're in there. Not you. No, the scallop. Let me see them hands.
It's not the same old West at Longhorn Steakhouse. Try our shrimp and scallop skewer with a tender flows filet. Longhorn Steakhouse. There's a new West in town.
Are you all right?
Yeah. So are you serious about that?
Yeah. If you drop a call, Alta will give you a credit automatically.
Wow.
When you get an automatic 1 minute credit for any call dropped on the Alta network, what's not to love?
IDT Tampa presents Strut. Tickets now on sale at Ticketmaster and the Academy Bookstore. Call 1-800-ACADEMY or visit academy.edu for more info.
If it's not broken, don't fix it.
No, don't fix it. That's the word from Governor Jeb Bush today. He vetoed the bill that would have forced drivers to move over to the right when other cars are trying to get by in the left lane on interstates. The governor said he doesn't see a problem that needs fixing. Plus, he felt the proposed law would have punished people who drive the speed limit, who don't get out of the way of speeders.
A bumpy ride for some Pasco County elementary students today when a van plowed into their bus. Take a look from Sky Fox right there. The front end of the van demolished at the intersection of Lancer and Nelson Roads in Hudson. Investigators tell us the driver of the van ran a stop sign. She and her three-year-old granddaughter were flown to the hospital for treatment. The kids on this bus from Shady Hills Elementary just have bumps and bruises. And earlier in the day, a school bus and a pickup got into a fender bender in Hernando County. The bus was stopped to pick up a student when a pickup truck rear-ended it. The driver of the pickup said the glare from the sun got in his eyes, prevented him from seeing the bus's taillights. He was treated for minor injuries.
Well, the survey's back, and it does not look good for the big gators of Lake Megory in St. Pete. A state-certified biologist estimates there are between 115 and 145 of these gators in St. Pete's largest lake. More than half of them are big ones, 9 feet or longer.
According to Fish and Wildlife standards, gators who are in that size range, 9 foot or greater, tend to present the greatest threat to public safety.
City officials want state experts to tell them how to balance safety concerns against the preservation goals of the adjacent Boyd Hill Nature Park. A decision on selectively removing these biggest critters could come within a month.
Well, the judge in the Michael Jackson trial refuses to allow testimony from CNN's Larry King.
And a terrible ending to what was supposed to be a fun balloon ride.
All right, see these guys there in the movie The Longest Yard, and if they look like they know what they're doing on the playing field, it's because of John Gruden. I'll explain why tonight in sports.
Some like things warm. Others cool. Which is why the Lexus ES is available with heated and ventilated front seats and dual zone climate control. So at least in one place, everyone is guaranteed to feel comfortable. At your local Lexus dealer today.
He wants the Kia Sedona minivan. She wants the Kia Sorento midsize SUV. How do they decide? Both have top safety ratings. Both have a 10-year warranty. Both have a 3.5-liter V6. How do they choose? Depends on where he wants to sleep tonight. The Kia Sedona and the Kia Sorento. Test drive two of the best values around $18,000. Visit your local Kia retailers. Hurry, offer ends soon.
Power traction control, ABS. It even comes in a sport wagon and a five-door. Man, this car sells itself. No offense.
People are getting the message. Mazda's on the move with Mazda 6. And now for a limited time, get up to $2,500 cash back on the 2005 Mazda 6 Sports Sedan. Check out the entire Mazda 6 series at your Mazda dealer now.
Fact one, they come equipped with uniquely advanced VTEC engine technology. Fact two, all three have been rated an excellent value by IntelliChoice. Fact three, Honda was rated best brand resale value. And if that's not enough, they all come with Honda's reputation for durability, the Element, the Pilot, and the CR-V. Now you can lease a Honda Pilot EX for $279 a month for well-qualified buyers.
Right now, during the Dodge Memorial Day event, even the deals are big. Grab Dodge Ram Thunder Road, featuring best-in-class available heavy power, best-in-class interior room, and 20-inch wheels. Now qualified returning Daimler Chrysler lessees can lease a Ram Quad SLT for $239 a month. So hurry to the Memorial Day sales event. Offers end May 31st.
Introducing the 300 horsepower Acura RL. With voice-activated technology and super-handling all-wheel drive, power can be shifted front to rear, side to side, and while cornering, the outside rear wheel is accelerated for dramatically improved handling in all weather conditions. The all-new Acura RL.
You're watching the Fox 13 10 o'clock news. It's the late news that's not too late.
The judge in Michael Jackson's trial says no to testimony today by CNN talk show host Larry King.
But yes to testimony from a Hollywood agent, though. An agent who says that the accusers never complained to her about the singer. Fox's Trace Gallagher has the story now from outside the courthouse in Santa Maria, California.
In a hearing outside the presence of the jury, Larry King said he had breakfast a while back with attorney Larry Feldman, who represented the boy who settled with Michael Jackson in 1994 for some $20 million, and also once represented the family in this case. On the stand 2 months ago, Feldman testified that he simply decided not to take this case. But Larry King says Feldman told him that Janet Arvizo, the mother of the current accuser, was, quote, wacko, and only in it for the money. The judge ruled the statement was improper opinion and would not allow King to take the stand.
The prosecution dodged a big bullet. If they could have gotten in evidence that the accuser's own lawyer said they were liars just looking for money, that would have perfectly encapsulated the defense theory, and I think it would have been devastating to their credibility.
The defense then called Aja Pryor, former girlfriend of actor-comedian Chris Tucker. Pryor, who broke down on the stand, says she knew the accuser's family well, loved the kids, and often spoke with the mother. But she says Janet Arvizo never told her she was being held against her will, and said she was excited about taping a rebuttal video because she felt the Bashir documentary wrongly portrayed the relationship between Michael Jackson and her son. At the end of court, the defense showed a videotaped tour of Neverland, including video and audio of the chimes that ring when you enter Michael Jackson's bedroom. The accuser's brother earlier testified that one night he went into Michael Jackson's bedroom unheard and saw Jackson molest his brother.
There are already problems with the brother's testimony. These chimes raise some doubt whether or not the boy could have heard it without Jackson reacting. In the end, that's all the defense needs is reasonable doubt.
Attorney Mark Garagus, Jay Leno, and Chris Tucker are believed to be the final big witnesses for the defense, which could rest late next week. Sources say the prosecution's rebuttal case will only take 2 days, which means the jury could have this case in 2 weeks. In Santa Maria, California, Trace Gallagher, Fox News.
46-year-old Jackson is accused of molestation, giving the boy wine, and conspiring to hold his family captive.
Charges tonight in a case that's becoming a thorn in the side for President Bush. Immigration officials are charging Cuban militant Luis Posada Carriles with entering the United States illegally. Fidel Castro says Posada is a terrorist and accused him of plotting the 1976 bombing of a Cuban airliner that killed 73 people. And Castro says granting Posada asylum would make the U.S. a hypocrite in the war on terror. The Bush administration is not doing that. They say Posada won't be sent, however, to Venezuela, which does want to try him for bombing there.
Two people lost their lives when their hot air balloon hit a power line in Louisiana. Witnesses said the basket caught fire. The two people either jumped or fell to their deaths. A man with a home video camera caught the balloon with no basket underneath it as it drifted to a nearby parking lot.
There was like flames dripping down from it, and then we saw a big piece, and it was very high up in the sky, and then we seen another piece.
And the FAA is now investigating exactly what happened.
Now, the police video we're about to show you is a little violent, but nobody was seriously hurt. A sheriff's deputy here in Minnesota, he was stopping to help a stranded motorist when an out-of-control pickup truck crashed into him. Here it is again. The officer went to the hospital, but the good news is he's already been treated and released. He's okay. And the man in the pickup is okay, too. But a man on a motorcycle tried to outrun police in North Carolina, and it started when an officer tried to pull him over in Burke County. Instead of stopping, he led police on a high-speed chase through three counties. It finally ended when a cruiser crashed into the motorcycle, sending it crashing to the ground. But this man wasn't hurt either. He survived, and he's in jail facing a number of charges.
And the FCC is ordering internet phone providers to make sure their 911 service is reliable. People with traditional phone service usually get a live dispatcher when they call 911. But those with phone service hooked up to the internet line sometimes get a recording. A Deltona woman who testified before the FCC says her baby died because she couldn't reach an operator. All internet phone providers now have 120 days to update their service and make sure an emergency dispatcher answers every time. Army National Guard soldiers just home from Iraq are now preparing to fight new battles in Florida.
Yeah, this controlled fire near Lakeland today was no match for the for Florida's newest firefighting tool, this Black Hawk helicopter. They call it Firehawk. It's got some special features, too. Unlike a regular Black Hawk, which scoops up 780 gallons in a water bucket here, this chopper carries a large water tank with a 10-foot snorkel that can fill this 1,000-gallon tank in just 45 seconds.
What I like about them is they're quicker getting to the fire scene because a bucket hanging underneath the helicopter reduces the airspeed about 30%.
Because of Florida's high fire danger, we're just one of six states to have a Firehawk like this. But this new aircraft tool doesn't come cheap. It costs the federal government $9 million.
Busch Gardens is showing off its newest ride tonight.
Now, Charlie Belcher checked it out for you today.
I'm Charlie Belcher. 200 feet straight up, a 90-degree angle drop. It's called Shikra. I've been on it. I survived, and I'll tell you about it if you just stay tuned.
Tomorrow, you could win front row seats to the big American Idol show coming this summer.
And Elvis will be in the building. It's a preview of Tampa's Elvis weekend.
All your news, weather, and traffic starts at 5 a.m.
on Good Day Tampa Bay tomorrow.
We saved the best.
There's a missile in the air carrying a nuclear warhead.
Will last. The two-hour season finale of 24.
It all starts Monday at 8 on Fox 13.
Baby back ribs.
Friday and Saturday nights at Golden Corral. Best rib deal in America. Ooh, baby. Only at Golden Corral.
From the day we're born, there are certain milestones we're each meant to celebrate. Before you know it, you're at the next one. And eventually, right back where you started. The Publix Bakery is happy to be part of all your life celebrations. Custom decorated cakes from the expert decorators at the Publix Bakery. Publix, where serving you has been our pleasure for 75 years.
Announcing the store-wide sale. This weekend at American Signature Furniture. Every sofa, every bedroom, every living room, every dining room, every mattress is on sale now. Save on fine furniture in every department. Exclusive handcrafted designs for every room in your home. Thousands of items all on sale. Hurry in for the best selection. Don't miss the store-wide sale. This week at American Signature Furniture.
Your forecast calls for the new Hyundai Santa Fe. With its standard V6 engine and standard ABS and traction control, it's the winner of Strategic Vision's 2004 Total Value Award. And Hyundai's quality lets us offer America's best warranty, 10 years, 100,000 miles. All for a sunny $4,800 less than a Toyota Highlander when comparably equipped. The Hyundai Santa Fe, starting at just $19,744. At Hyundai. Get a 2005 Hyundai Santa Fe with up to $2,500 cash back at your local Hyundai dealer.
Why have four wheels if you're not going to use them? The Subaru Legacy with symmetrical all-wheel drive standard. With an available 250-horsepower turbocharged boxer engine, it's a performance sedan like no other. And now, for a limited time, take advantage of this special offer on 2005 Legacy models. Think, feel, drive one today.
Through May 31st, receive up to $1,500 cash savings on select 2005 Legacy models.
Mommy. I'm hungry.
Alarm clocks. They deserve a good meal. Like the wide variety of omelets and eggs at Golden Corral, all made to order. Plus grilled ham and smoked sausages and much more, all on the breakfast buffet. Golden Corral. Everyone deserves a good meal.
This segment is sponsored by Walmart.
You're watching the Fox 13 10 o'clock news, where there's no world like Charlie's world.
In Charlie's world tonight, it's a good one. It's Shikra.
Shikra, the latest thrill ride opening this weekend at Busch Gardens in Tampa. And it is called a dive roller coaster. It's a one of a kind for North America. 200 feet up in the air, 90 degree drop straight down. And our own thrill seeker, Charlie Belcher, was coaxed into taking a test ride.
Busch Gardens built a monster. And it's called Shikra.
Oh, I really can't wait. It's going to be the best day of my life.
How old are you?
I'm 10.
Yeah, you don't have much life yet, so that may be. Yeah. Alex Bluestein is an expert in roller coasters. He knows them inside and out. His brother, Zach, is looking forward to it, too.
Adrenaline.
I'm an adrenaline junkie.
It's amazing. It's the first one to have a 90-degree drop. I mean, first kind of diving machine in America. It's great.
It's insane, man.
It's more than insane.
It's insane.
It's more than insane, I gotta tell you.
But I mean insane bad. He means insane good. The kids want me to go with them, but I don't know. I need some convincing. Then I saw some of my heroes do it. Tampa Bay Buccaneers themselves. Check out brave Derek Brooks and Shelton Quarles.
Does this look like fun?
The intense wind going 70 miles an hour made wide receiver Michael Clayton's eyes water. Of course, that's not what it looked like to his teammates.
Oh, man. Michael Clayton over here crying.
I don't really never feel that type of discomfort in my stomach on the football field.
It's weird to be hanging over the edge and then finally drop. It was crazy.
It is definitely a ride, man. It's two big, exciting drops in this ride, and it's something that you want to do.
Okay, if they say so, where's my partner?
Shikra on three. Ready? One, two, three. Shikra!
Okay, there we are to the right of your screen in the front row, and here we go. Let me tell you, this is 3 minutes of major intensity, but we survived, barely. Fortunately, I had my two friends to help me through it.
It was cool just hanging there and then all of a sudden going. It was really cool.
It was the best. I really loved it.
So what do you think? You guys going to ride it again?
Yeah.
All right, let's go. Come on, let's go. Let's go. No way. Reporting from Charlie's World, I'm Charlie Belcher.
Shikra opens to the public this weekend.
Charlie's okay.
He's okay. I knew he would survive.
Two helpers holding him up.
He can get by Simon and Paula and that crowd and Randy and American Idol. He can handle that.
Yes, he certainly can. Hurricane Adrian is continuing to move toward El Salvador.
Yeah, Paul's got the latest on that when we come back.
You can see one.
A Tampa-based technology company changes the way baseball teams do business.
Before, it was a needle in a haystack.
I'm Chris Field. I'll show you how eSolutions sorts confidential information for baseball's best teams.
Sorted multiple.
I was 16 when I left.
I left when I was 14.
I was 13.
Polygamy's lost boys, driven into the streets by jealous polygamist men. Also, forget Bigfoot, video of The Doors' Jim Morrison. Jim Morrison lives on the next A Current Affair.
See it tomorrow at 7 on Fox 13.
Chevy Trailblazer LS four-wheel drive versus Ford Explorer XLS 4x4. With Chevy Trailblazer, you get more standard horsepower, more city miles per gallon, and more interior room. Chevy Trailblazer, more sport, more utility. Now use hot button bonus to lease an 05 Chevy Trailblazer for around $259 a month. Residency restrictions apply. Call for details. See your Southern Chevy dealers.
We're on a journey to find real people.
Yeah.
Who love their Weber grills.
Look, no wiggle, no jiggle.
Like Jim Kwan.
People know where I stand.
And his wife, Joyce.
He loves his Weber.
Well, Weber does everything well.
It's really well made. Every other grill that I've ever had before I got this Weber, no grill lasted more than two seasons.
Real people with real passion.
I baked a cake in it.
For their Weber grills.
It's great.
See more stories or share your own at WeberNation.com. Maybe we'll be visiting you.
Hey, what's the hurry? Everyone's going to VisionWorks' best sale of the year. Right now at the VisionWorks half-off sale, you can save 50% off a complete pair of glasses. That's half off any pair in the store until this Saturday. So there's no time to wait. VisionWorks, why pay more?
Cause it's bigger in the new South, better in a Dodge.
Right now, during the Dodge Memorial Day event, even the deals are big. Grab the Dodge Dakota with 5-star frontal crash test rating, best-in-class torque, and the largest overall interior room. Now qualified returning Daimler Chrysler owners and lessees can lease a Dakota Club ST with a V6 for $149 a month. So hurry to the Memorial Day sales event. Offers end May 31st.
This week you attended a conference in Portland, a meeting in Dallas, and a presentation in Atlanta. Now it's time to do a little catching up on what's been going on at home. The Tampa Tribune. Life. Printed daily.
Never love, oh baby, we'll travel.
The all-new 300 horsepower Land Rover LR3, the 2005 Motor Trend Sport Utility of the Year, nicely equipped at $599 a month.
Here are the stocks tonight. They closed higher on Wall Street. The Dow rose 26 points, actually 28 points. The NASDAQ gained almost 12, and the S&P was up almost 5.5. Big mess in New Zealand after some torrential rains.
Flash floods and landslides have heavily damaged homes and swamped entire farms on the country's North Island. A state of emergency has been declared. They had 16 inches of rain that fell in just 36 hours. It's the region's first worst deluge on record, and more rain is in the forecast.
Mm. More rain heading toward El Salvador.
Yeah, a lot of it.
I just saw Charlie Belcher in the hall. He's looking kind of green.
You know, he said he was a little bit on the weak side. Would you do that?
No. I'm still getting over teacups at Disney. Once I get past that, I'm going to be all
Dumbo,
set.
Dumbo, forget Dumbo.
Dumbo, Splash Mountain, that's about
the
extent.
He has trouble in the vending machine.
Vending machine, sure. When that thing spins around, oh, it's big trouble. Let's talk about big weather in the West. Seattle, Washington, severe storms of all places. I mean, you know, it rains in Seattle, but they usually don't get severe thunderstorms. That was the case earlier today with many spots getting heavy rain, even some small hail. In the great Pacific Northwest, we had big rain in Pinellas County and along US 19 up by Port Richey in Hudson earlier today. That rain now is moving offshore. The rest of tonight will be quiet under mostly clear skies. There'll be a band of rain tomorrow near Atlanta and 77, a muggy 90 in the Big Easy, Little Rock up to 90, Dallas heating up to 95, St. Louis 72 in the west, Phoenix 106. Denver 91. It seems like just a couple of days ago, maybe a week or two, where they were plowing some snow in Denver. They'll be 91 tomorrow and 85 in Salt Lake City. The outlook for the Sky Tower 7-day talks about a few showers through Sunday, and then we'll be drier and still hot on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. John and Kelly.
All right. Thank you so much, yep. Paul. And now Chip's here talking about the Rays, and finally.
We have something good to talk about.
Well, I'm glad.
Well, it's been a long run for this team on the road, I'll tell you that. The Rays were just due for a win after losing 7 road games this month. Something had to go their way. It was Scott Kazmir holding Detroit hitless for 3 2/3. Let's pick up the highlights. Damon Hollins, the 2-run homer, and it's 4-0 Rays. They crank out 13 hits this afternoon. And then they continue to pour it on. Nick Green gives Kazmir a 6-0 cushion. Kazmir pitches 3 2/3 of hitless baseball. Then he himself gets hit. Drilled in the knee by Dimitri Young, walks off on his own. He retired the first 8 batters, didn't give up a hit until the 4th. Rays win it 6-2, and they now head to Florida to crank up interleague play. Class 4A softball semis. Bartow's Lindsay Littlejohn just dominates Coco. She fires a no-hitter, strikes out 13. She also delivers at the plate. That's a nice swing. Launching a 2-run shot on the 4th to break up a scoreless tie, Bartow advances to his 8th straight championship game, winning 5-0 in the 2A semifinal. McKeel of Lakeland goes to the title game. They shut out Trinity Christian 7-0. You know, some of the plays in The Longest Yard, the movie, look familiar. It's because they came out of John Gruden's playbook. Gruden told us he will take the entire team to the movie when it opens next week. Now, when the producers from Hollywood called him on the phone to work on the film as a consultant, he thought it was somebody playing a joke on him.
I just got a phone call one day, and the guy says, "Hey, would you like to be interested in doing this?" I thought it was a prank phone call. Get the hell out of here, man. No, I'm serious. So I said, yeah, shoot. They sent me the script. They asked me to read the script. And being one that doesn't sleep much, I wasn't much of a problem. And, you know, I just, when they came and met with me, it was only a couple hours. And I just gave them the feedback that hopefully they were looking for.
All right, Viking running back Ontario Smith is out for the year because he skipped a drug test. If a player does that, the league regards that as a positive test. Smith already had 2 strikes against him, and he was caught with a device called the Wizinator, which is designed to beat drug tests. That couldn't be good either. Remember the rumors about Jerry Rice coming to Tampa? Forget them. Rice is talking with Denver right now. Mike Shanahan was the offensive coordinator for San Francisco when Rice played there. Denver says if he ends up signing, it'll be as a backup. And reports have Kellen Winslow done for the season with a torn ACL in his right knee. He was in the hospital 9 days after crashing his motorcycle onto the curb. Winslow broke a clause in his contract by riding that motorcycle, and the Browns could, and I do think they should, get part of his 6-year, $40 million deal back. You know, they got clauses for stuff like that. Game 6 of the Eastern Conference semifinals just about to end. In fact, they are over. The Pistons are going to beat Indiana, winning the series 4-2 and ending the career of Reggie Miller, who is retiring. All right? Now, if you want to put a successful baseball team on the field, you've got to be a number cruncher. A Tampa-based company makes the process easier for 10 major league teams. Chris Field shows us how this works next.
We saved the best.
There's a missile in the air carrying a nuclear warhead.
For last. The 2-hour season finale of 24.
It all starts Monday at 8 on Fox 13.
And when it's open, the game's not.
Right now, when you buy or lease the all-new Grand Cherokee, you'll get a 20-gigabyte Apple iPod capable of holding 5,000 songs at no extra charge. The all-new Jeep Grand Cherokee is totally redesigned with a new interior, new exterior, new steering, new suspension, and an available Hemi engine. Buy or lease one and get an easy-to-use iPod at no extra charge. See your Jeep dealer today.
And as you can see, the new Jetta is a lot roomier inside.
I like that.
It has a multifunction trip computer.
Mm.
Dual zone climate control, so you can have your side and he can have his side.
I like that.
The engine's all new, more powerful.
Good.
6-disc in-dash CD changer with MP3 capability.
It's nice, isn't it? Dave.
Redesigned suspension so the Jetta handles is better.
Mm.
And of course, power seats.
Of course.
The new, very well-equipped Jetta. Come drive it. You'll get it.
Out of all the car dealers on the web, only one connects you to the largest selection of cars and trucks in the world, AutoWay.com. Click AutoWay.com to shop over 100,000 cars and trucks, virtually every make, every model. You can even ask for an AutoWay discounted price on every vehicle. Right there, Marino?
Our AutoWay discounted prices are always low, always up front. Just go to AutoWay.com. It just keeps getting easier.
AutoWay!
Call 1-800-SHOP-AUTOWAY or AutoWay.com.
Dedicated to bringing you the finest, freshest produce, meats, and seafood, all at great prices, so you can bring that freshness home to the people you care about. Cash and Carry, fresh to your table.
You know, this book, Moneyball, explains how Oakland general manager Billy Beane made the most of one of the lowest payrolls in baseball by crunching and concentrating on key stats, while the rest of baseball took notice. So did a Tampa technology company. Chris Field shows us how eSolutions changes the way baseball teams do business.
The Boston Red Sox are world champions.
The Red Sox are clients. So are the Cardinals. The Yankees, too. Three of last season's four championship series teams all on board, along with the Angels, Athletics, Braves, Nationals, Orioles, Padres, and Tigers. Tampa-based eSolutions hits a home run with Scout Advisor. This software system helps 10 teams make critical personnel decisions every day.
You see the cameras everywhere you go in the perimeter. In fact, you saw the elevator trying to get up. You couldn't unless somebody helped you. That's all about the security of the place as well. I'll take you inside where all the nuggets of gold are.
Major League Baseball feeds every iota of player statistical and biographical information to eSolutions each night.
At this data center, 23 servers are working for the 10 baseball teams. But eSolutions does a lot more than just baseball. They have 230 other clients using about 1,500 servers.
High-powered business partners help make this possible. eSolutions guarantees system accessibility. They also have people ready to help around the clock.
I can launch the amateur scouting program, the professional scouting program, international.
Teams plug in scouts notes, confidential evaluations, all their field work. They have everything they need at their fingertips.
Yeah, in this particular launch page,
it's incredible how exclusive and secret this information is, especially on their reports, the proprietary evaluations on either amateurs or pros. Those are absolutely sacred.
Say Derek Jeter lands on the disabled list. The Yankees evaluate talent available in their farm system, in all of baseball, looking at arm speed, batting average, salary, any criteria they choose.
We essentially create these views where you can sort this data six ways to Sunday.
What used to take days takes minutes with Scout Advisor.
Absolutely big gain in efficiency in terms of being able to find what they want. Evaluate a player, whether it's a statistical or psychological profiling on his mental capabilities. This is all in there as well.
This system removes the guessing from daily decisions, from draft day decisions.
We're going to do anything for these teams. We absolutely love these teams and their clients, and if they say jump, we say how high.
The cost runs from $50,000 to $75,000, depending on customizations. Not a big investment when it comes to making million-dollar decisions. In Tampa, Chris Field, Fox 13 Sports.
Less than $100,000 a year, a bargain for big money teams when you have a system that sorts stats like that. Now, Fortune Small Business Magazine thinks so, too. They profile eSolutions and Scout Advisor in their May edition. eSolutions got into baseball by helping the Yankees tweak their homegrown system in 99. Then they developed their system and sold it to the Yankees a couple of years later. So the company has similar software and development for the NFL. That should be ready a little later this year, and then for the NBA next year as well. So
wow. Any team who doesn't do it is going to be, you know,
they'll be behind. I mean, everybody will have to do it just to stay on the same playing field.
Exactly. That's great. Yeah. Thank you.
All right.
Chip.
All right. We'll be back in a minute.
Last year's hurricane season proved it's more important than ever to be prepared. Our new 2005 online guide has updated evacuation maps, plus a printable tracking chart and a complete shopping supply list. Fox 13's Hurricane and Severe Weather Guide. We've got you covered on WTVT.com.
Retirement, as we know it, will soon be retired. How do we know? We're Allianz Life, the best at next.
It's tough to catch some Z's. Want to catch some? Find the right mattress at Mattress Giant.
National brands are now 50% off at the Mattress Giant Memorial Day Sale. 50% off any size of a Serta Perfect Sleeper set. Save hundreds and enjoy 0% interest for 24 months at Mattress Giant's Memorial Day Sale.
Only at Mattress Giant.
Ooh, ah.
Hurry into Sears Optical for a complete pair of eyeglasses for just $97. Any prescription, over 500 frames, and ultralight lenses with no-line bifocals, just $97. Hurry, sale ends soon. Sears, good life, great price.
Fire ants keeping you off your lawn? Take it back with Top Choice. Just one application of professional strength Top Choice keeps your lawn fire ant free for a full year, guaranteed. It's powerful science in the fight against fire ants. Want proof? Ask your lawn care or pest control service about Top Choice or check out nofireants.com.
The 2005 Chevy Colorado Street Pack. It's got aluminum wheels, fog lamps, body-colored grille, and more. All starting under $16,100. Chevy Colorado Street Pack. A lot of extras for not a lot extra. Now use hot button bonus to lease a 2005 Chevy Colorado with available Street Pack for around $169 a month. Hurry, hot button ends May 31st. See your Southern Chevy dealers.
Satellite TV. See if it's right for your ride. Friday at 10.
We have an update now on some breaking news we told you about earlier tonight.
Sky Fox shows Interstate 4 eastbound still shut down tonight near Plant City. Two people have been killed in a multi-car accident. Troopers are diverting traffic off the interstate at Thanon Assasa, and eastbound traffic is backed up for miles. Investigators aren't sure how much longer the interstate's going to be closed while they do their work investigating what happened.
Now, before we go here tonight on Fox TV, you know, when you have one of these old houses, you never know what you're going to find. Well, in Massachusetts, workers found a half-finished bottle of whiskey in a wall as they were working on a chimney. It's almost 200 years old. The bottle label says it was made in 1812. The owners of the house...